Gas prices are going up across the country after Harvey. They have jumped almost 20 cents since the storm made landfall 1 week ago today. The national average is now $2.52, and that's the highest average price in at least 2 years. In Dallas, drivers waited in line to fill up yesterday, and they were worried that refinery and pipeline shutdowns along the Gulf Coast would cause a gas shortage. Lima Croft is the global head of commodity strategy for RBC Capital Markets, and she joins us at the table to discuss. Really good to see you, Halima
Croft. Thank you for having me on.
Heading into this Labor Day weekend, this is not the news people want to hear. How long do you think this spike will last?
Depends really on the infrastructure damage. We simply don't know when we're going to get the refineries back up and running. We currently have 10 refineries down. That's 16% of all U.S. refining capacity. And we don't know when the facilities will be up and running, when people can get back to work, what the extent of the damage is. So we're really going to need to sort of play a bit of a waiting game to see when we can get gas prices back to more normal levels.
This is going to have a big impact on the Colonial Pipeline.
Yes.
A lot of people aren't aware of this one. It runs from Houston all the way to New York.
That's why we get higher gas prices here when you get a storm in the Gulf Coast. One out of every 8 barrels that people consume comes through the Colonial Pipeline. It is a major transit route for gasoline, for jet fuel, for distillates. It supplies the East Coast of the United States. So when we have problems on that pipeline, we see higher gas prices here.
A lot of us of a certain vintage, Halima, can remember the long lines in the 70s during the OPEC oil crisis. And of course, there were lines after Hurricane Sandy. Could we see the same thing at this time?
Well, after the oil embargo in the 70s, we created a strategic petroleum reserve that we can tap in emergency situations. We actually tapped the strategic petroleum reserve yesterday, 1 million barrels for refineries in Louisiana. The U.S. government does have additional tools at its disposal if it wants to basically help get supplies to different parts of the country. It could remove the Jones Act, which requires only U.S. ships to transport refined products and crude throughout the country. So it can do other things to ease a supply problem.
Well, I'm certainly part of that vintage that pointed out at the you too. But this is so much bigger than just a Texas problem, is it not?
Absolutely. I mean, when we go back to 2005, the U.S. basically exported around 800,000 barrels of refined product. We now export 6 million barrels of crude and refined product. So you have global markets dependent on U.S. supplies. Mexico, half of their gasoline comes from the United States. So we're starting to see shortages and problems outside the United States. It's a global problem, not just a local problem.
Okay. Halima Croft, thank you so much
for the
insight.
Thank you.